Hi everyone, can you hear me? Okay, perfect. In the previous session, we learned date and date time classes. We completed string class. I hope everyone could solve the questions in the book. Today, we will start to learn if statement and ternary statement. Let us put a heading over here. If statement. If statement in Apex uses the same logic with if statement in English. Let us type an if statement in English. For example, if your GPA is greater than 3.8, you can get scholarship. This is a sentence in English. Okay. In that sentence, there are two parts. This is the first part. Your GPA is greater than 3.8. This is first part. This is the second part. In the first part, there is a condition. In the second part, there is result. First part, that one is condition. This is condition. And the second part, that part is the action. This is the action. If first part is true, I mean, your GPA is greater than 3.8. If the condition is true, that one will be active. Second part will be active. You will get scholarship. But if the first part is not true, your GPA is not greater than 3.8, you will not have scholarship. Second part will not be active. This is the structure of if sentence in English. Apex used the same structure. Let us type that sentence in Apex. You will type if. Type if, please. And then open close parenthesis. Open curly brace. It will be closed automatically. No need to close it. And then press enter. This is the structure of if statement in Apex. Type if keyword. Regular parenthesis, curly braces. This is the if statement structure. In if sentence, there are two parts, condition part, action part. Condition part will be typed inside the regular parenthesis. Action part will be typed over here between the curly braces. Let us make it. I wanna create a decimal GPA variable. Type decimal GPA equals to 3.9, for example. This is greater than 3.8. Inside the parenthesis, I will type the condition. What is the condition? GPA will be greater than 3.8. GPA greater than 3.8. This is my condition. If the condition is true, student should get the scholarship. Let us type it over here. System.debug, you won the scholarship. If GPA is greater than 3.8, that part will be active. Otherwise, student will not get the scholarship. Let us highlight and execute the code. Slow again. Can you see? You won the scholarship. Because GPA is 3.9, it is greater than 3.8, that code was executed. Let us change the GPA to 3.0, for example. You shouldn't see that message because the condition is false. Look at the black part. If the condition is false, second part shouldn't work. Highlight and execute. Can you see? It doesn't tell you won the scholarship because GPA is not greater than 3.8. Let me draw that one, how Java is, how Apex is working over here. Apex is coming from top over here. Apex understood the value of GPA is 3.0. And then Apex will come to the if part. For GPA, it will put 3.0 over here. It will read the condition. It says 3.0 is greater than 3.8. This is false, everyone. Can you see? Condition is false. If the condition is false, Apex doesn't read that part. Apex skips that part. Okay. That part will not be executed. Because of that, you don't see over here anything. But let us change the GPA. I will change GPA to 3.9. Again, Apex will come from top. It understood the value of GPA is 3.9. And then it will come over here. The value of GPA is 3.9. Check the condition. 3.9 is greater than 3.8. that statement is true. If it is true, Apex will come and execute that code. That code is printing, you won the scholarship. Because of that, you saw that one over here. Okay. By using if statement, we can execute some codes under some specific conditions. I will tell to Apex, hey, Apex, that code should be executed under that condition. Another code should be executed under another condition. For example, if you enter your username and password correctly, application will take you to homepage. This is an action. If you enter username and password, application will give you a notification. This is another action. As you see, giving notification will be executed under invalid password. Navigating to home page will be executed under valid password. According to the password, you will do different actions. We can achieve that behavior in Apex by using if statement. I hope the logic of if statement is clear and the benefit of if statement is clear. Actually, this is a simple implementation, Merve, but we will do more. Okay. That's it. When you execute that code, everyone. Yes, Korkut. Use curly braces every time. You will see someone doesn't use curly braces, but it has risk. Put curly braces every time. It is the better practice. Okay. Pay attention, please. Over here, when the GPA is greater than 3.8, I am getting a message. But when I make it less than 3.8, it is not telling me anything. Can you see? It didn't tell me anything. This is not good practice, everyone. For every scenario, user should get a message from the application. Otherwise, user will think application is not working. How can we do it? I will put one more if statement over here. Put it, please. One more if statement. I will tell GPA is less than or equal to 3.8. That one is covering greater than 3.8. That one is covering the other scenario. To be equal to or less than 3.8. Over here, I will tell you couldn't win. You couldn't win the scholarship. Let us execute the code. OK. Can you see? It says you couldn't win. It's okay. When I make it 3.9, it will tell me you won. For every scenario, I am giving message to the user. This is good now. Okay. Let us see. What is Apex doing over here? Apex understood the value of GPA is 3.9. Okay. It will check the condition. 3.9 is greater than 3.8. This is true. Okay. That code will be executed. And then Apex will come over here. The condition will be false because 3.9 is not less than or equal to 3.8. That code will not be executed. Apex will do that one. Okay. Okay. As you see over here, Apex checked two conditions. Apex checked two conditions. Let me test the same code with 3.0. Change the value to 3.0 over here, okay? And then this is 3.0. When you put 3.0 over here, the condition will be false. That code will not be executed over here. And then Apex will come over here. The condition will be true because 3.0 is less than 3.8. It will be true. That code will be executed. You will see that message. Again, Apex checked two conditions. In the first if, a condition was checked. In the second if, second condition was checked. Okay. Everyone, checking condition. Checking condition is a task for Apex. Apex will do a task over here, another task over here. For a single scenario, doing two tasks is not preferable. Let us improve that code. Pay attention. I will type if again. If GPA is greater than 3.8, student will win the scholarship. Everyone, if the GPA is greater than that, scholarship will be won. Otherwise, student cannot win the scholarship. Otherwise means else in Apex. Okay. Otherwise means else. Over here, you can put that one. Okay. Let us highlight and execute. I will get same result from both. That one and that one will give me the same output. Highlight and execute. Can you see? I got the same output. Let us test the scenario with 3.9. This is positive scenario. It will give me the same output again. Same output. Okay. I can solve that question in two ways. This is first way, this is second way. Which one is better? If Apex works less, it will be better. In the first solution, Apex was checking two conditions. Let us look at the second one. How many conditions will be checked? GPA is 3.9. Apex understood it. And then it came over here. This is true. Okay. This is true. That one will be executed. In if else structure, if any part was executed, Apex doesn't read others. Okay, I'm repeating. In if else structure, if any part was executed, Apex doesn't read the other. Else part will not be read. Can you see over here, Apex checked just one condition. So let us put a note over here. Apex checked one condition. For the positive scenario, second way is better because over here, two conditions were checked. Over here, one condition was checked. Second one is good for positive scenario. Let us look at the negative scenario. I will change the GPA to 3.0 and then I will look at the flow. This is 3.0. Okay. Apex understood GPA is 3.0. Will come over here. 3.0 is greater than 3.8. This is false. If it is false, Apex doesn't execute that code. It will come to else part. As you see, in the else part, there is no any condition. That code will be executed automatically. In the second part, no condition check. If first part is wrong, second part will be executed automatically. Can you see again in if else, just one condition checked. Because of that, instead of typing multiple if, we use if else. Is this clear? I am clearing the screen. Okay. Let us put a note over here. This is the first way. Okay. This is the second way. If it is possible, use if else instead of multiple if statements. If statements. because it will make your code faster. But to be able to use if else, you have just two options. For example, if a number is positive, you will type positive. Otherwise, you will type negative. Can you use if else over here? Let me put an example. I will make that one example one. Let us make it example two. If a number is positive, print positive. Otherwise, print negative. I will remove that part. If a number is positive, print positive. This is our task. Let us try to do it. I will create a number. Let us make it integer. Integer I equals to 12, for example. I will type if statement. If I is greater than zero, positive means greater than zero. Because of that, I typed if I is greater than zero. I will print over here system.debug positive. Let us execute the code. It should give me positive because 12 is positive. It is okay. Let us make it negative. I'm making negative 12. Execute the code. You will see nothing on the console because my code is doing nothing for the negative scenario. How can I fix it? Let us put over here else. It will print negative. Make it negative. It will give me negative. It is okay. But pay attention, there is a problem in that code. Because if I make the value zero, it will tell me negative. But zero is not negative actually. Okay, this is a problem. Everyone, in that question, there are three options. Being positive is an option. Being negative is second option. Being neutral is the third option. Okay. But if else can be used just with two options. You cannot use if else in more than two options. It gives you error for the third scenario. Is this clear, everyone? We will fix that one. We will fix that one. Let me clear over here. Let us fix it. Everyone, after typing first condition, this is positive condition. I will type over here, else if, okay, else if I is less than zero, okay, it will print negative. Can you see? Else if, after else, you may put one more condition. If you have more than two conditions. First condition is okay. Second condition is okay. I have just third condition. For the third condition, you may type just else. Make it neutral. Okay. Now let us see the output. Can you see? It tells me neutral. It is okay. For zero, it did correct. For negative value, can you see it says negative? For positive value, it says positive. Everything is okay. So, if you have just two conditions, use if else. If you have more than two conditions, use if, else if, at the end use else. This is the best practice. Let us draw the flow over here. As you see, I equals to 12. Apex understood. I is 12. Put 12 over here. 12 is greater than 0. This is true. If the condition is true, Apex will execute the code under that condition. That one will be executed. Because of that, you got positive over here. Everyone, in, if, else, if, else, if, else, after finding true, Apex doesn't read the others. That part will not be read by Apex. You may have 100 conditions over here. After finding true in the first condition, 99 of them will not be read. You have 100 conditions. Apex found the true in third condition. 97 of them will not be read. You have 100 conditions. Apex found the true in 99th one. Apex will not read the last condition. Okay. This is perfect. Apex will save time by the help of the if, else, if, else, if. Okay, let us draw second scenario. I will make it negative 12. Okay. The value of I is negative 12. Put negative 12 over here. Negative 12 is greater than zero. This is false. If this is false, that code will not be executed. What will Apex do? Apex is looking for true. Because of that, it will come to the second condition. In the second condition, put negative 12 over here, less than zero. This is true, everyone. This is true. If it is true, that code will be executed and Apex will stop reading the remaining parts. That part will not be read by Apex. In the third scenario, I will change the number to 0. The value of I is 0. That condition is false because 0 doesn't greater than 0. That code will not be executed. Apex is looking for true. It couldn't find yet. It will come to the next condition. 0 is less than 0. It is false again. Okay, it is false. That code will not be executed. What will Apex do? Apex will come to the else part. Over here, there is no any condition. That one will be executed. You will see nötr on the console. Yes, Hale, you can use it. We will do examples. Okay, is there any question about the second example? When to use else if? For two options, if else is enough. For more than two options, you should use if, else if. Okay. Okay. Pay attention, please. This is number line. Zero is in the middle. Before zero, there are negative numbers. After zero, there are positive numbers. Can you see in the first part over here, I worked with positive values. In the second part, can the others see, Merve? Why cannot you see anything? Did you turn on the computer? What about the others? Is there any problem? Okay. Merve, don't forget to open your eyes as well. And maybe it is midnight in your country. Okay. Yes, most probably. Most probably. Okay, first part, everyone, pay attention. This is very important. First part, I worked with positive values. Look at the second part. In the second part, I worked with negative values. This is the second one. At the end, over here, I worked with zero, nötr. This is the third one, zero. Everyone, this is not good. Why? Because I started from here, I came over here, and then I came back to zero. This is not good practice. When you use if, else if, you should start from right and go to the left. This is the first option. You can do that one. Or you can start from left, go to the right. This is the second option. Which one should be used? From right to left or left to right? It depends on the task. It depends on the requirement. But don't do that one. Right and then left and then middle. Don't use that complicated order. Make it from left to right or right to left or left to right. Okay. I am repeating. When you use if, else if, else if, the order of conditions is important. When you change order, sometimes you may get weird outputs. We will do examples about it. Okay. Let us do one more example. Example 3. If age is less than 18, print child. Let's make it 13. Print child. If age is less than 18, less than 20, print teenager. Okay. If age is less than 40, print mid age. If age is greater than or equal to 40, print senior. This is our task. It has to do it together. I will create an age container. It will be integer. Integer age equals to, let us make it 12 at the beginning. After typing my code, we will test our code with all scenarios. Oruzbek, this is your first session. If you missed the previous, did you start from the first session? When you start to learn English, Oruzbek, you think we are learning so many rules, there are many rules, how will I memorize them? But now you are speaking English. It is same in Apex. After learning rules in live sessions, you will do practice and then everything will be easy. But if you don't do practice, nothing is easy. Okay, if everyone, it says age is less than 13. Let us type it. Age is less than 13. I will print over here, child. First one is okay. Let us look at the second one. If age is less than 20, I will type over here, else if, this is another condition. Why am I using else if? Because there are more than two conditions. Less than 13, less than 20, less than 40, greater than 40. There are more than two conditions. Because of that, I am using else if. Age is less than 20, I will print a teenager. And then there is one more, else if age is less than 40, I am typing that one, I will print mid age. If H is greater than or equal to 4D. Everyone, to be less than 13, 20, 4D. This is the all others. Highlighted part means all the other H's. I will put over here just else. No need to put condition. Because if you put condition, Apex will check it. A checking condition will need time. It will make the Apex slower. If it is not must, don't put condition. I will type over here, senior. Okay. Let us execute. For 12, I should see child. As you see, it is okay. Let us make it 18. 18 is not less than 13. That part is true. I should see teenager. I will draw that one. Can you see it says teenager? Let me make it like that. Okay. H is 18. Put 18 over here. It says 18 is less than 13. It is false. If it is false, that code will not be executed. You will not see child over here. It is okay. Apex checked the condition, it is false. It is looking for true. Because of that, it will come to the second condition to find true. This is 18. 18 is less than 20. This is true. If it is true, you will have that one on the console, as you see. We got it. And the rest of the codes will not be read by Apex. Apex doesn't read that part. Okay. Let us change the value to 35, for example. I will draw 35. H is 35. First condition is false, everyone. This is false. If it is false, that code will not be executed. Apex will come to the second part. 35 is less than 20. It is false. No execution for teenager. And then come over here. 35 is less than 4D. This is true. After finding true, Apex will execute that code and then will not read that part. Okay. If you change the value to 60, that one will be false. That one will be false. That one will be false. Just else part will be executed. You will see senior over here. Pay attention. I told you the order of conditions is important when you use else if, else if, else if. Let us see it. I will put H is less than 20 over here, less than 13 over here, and I wanna use 18. Normally, 18 should be teenager, but when you execute the code, it will tell you child. Can you see it says child? Why? When you run the code, Apex understood H is 18. It came over here. In the first condition, can you see 18 is less than 20? It prints child over here. Or let us do that one. Let us do that one. For less than 20, I will put teenager as well. And let us make that one child. Okay. Because in the task, it says less than 20, print teenager. Okay. Less than 20, I am printing teenager. Less than 13, print child. Less than 13, print child. According to the task, I typed my code. Just I didn't put the values in order. Put over here 12. Okay. For 12, according to task, I should get child, but it will tell me teenager. Can you see it says teenager? Normally, less than 13 must be child, but it says teenager. Why? Because that one will be true. 12 is less than 20 true, you will have teenager. Okay. I gave that example to teach you the importance of the order in else if. Is this clear, everyone? Okay, I will change those again. What do you think? Is the task completed, everyone? Is the task completed? I think you missed some curly braces, Furkan. Copy and paste my code, it will work. Yes, everyone, that task was not completed. Why? Because this is user. User can enter negative values for the ages. Normally, user shouldn't do that kind of things, but can. Users can. Let us run that code. It will tell me what? Child. This is not good, everyone. For negative ages, we should give a notification to the user. I should tell negative values are not acceptable for the ages, that kind of message. How will I do it? Everyone, I will put one more if over here. One more if. If age is less than zero, zero age is possible because newborn babies are in zero age, but less than zero is not acceptable. I will put over here negative values are not valid for ages. Okay. Can you see this is first condition? So for that one, I have to use else. Else, I put else and then I took it over here. If the age is negative, it will give error message. If age is not negative, it will select any one of them. Now this is okay. Let us execute the code. Can you see? It says negative values are not valid for ages. It's okay. All scenarios are done. Is there any question about third example? Of course, if you want, but that data will come from user. If user enters negative value, you should give error message. What can you do else? In real applications, it is like that. Don't use negative values. Okay. That one is doing it. User, if user wants to enter negative values, he can, you cannot prevent him. But after getting negative value, you will give error message and you will not let user to proceed. We do that one every time. Okay. I want you to do that one. Example 4. I am waiting for you for 3 minutes to do that one. You will enter initials of the days, it will print the day names. Okay, let us start to do it. I will create a string container to put initial. String, I will name it as S equals to, let us make it S. Okay. STR. Okay. The initial is S. I will tell to Apex, hey, Apex, if my string equals to S, that one equals to S, it will print Sunday, Saturday. Okay. As you know, for strings, we don't use double equal sign. We use equals method. Okay. String, that one, equals to S, it will print Sunday and Saturday. Another condition, str equals T. Which days start with T? Tuesday and Thursday. I will change those Tuesday and Thursday. Okay. This is the second one. and then else if str equals Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, W, it will print Wednesday. Okay. And I have Friday. Else, Friday is the last option. For the last option, no need to put else, but this is user. User can put X as well. Because of that, for Friday, I will put condition again. str dot equals f, it will print Friday. Two, four, five, six. Which one? I forgot. Sunday, Monday. I forgot Monday. Else if str dot equals M, okay, it will print Monday. At the end, I will type else, why? Because user can put X for initial, but weekdays don't have X initial. I will put over here, enter a valid initial. Okay, enter a valid initial. Let us run the code. Can you see for S, it printed Sunday, Saturday. It worked. Let us change it to T. It should give me Tuesday and Thursday. It worked as well. I will test my code with X. X doesn't exist in day names as initial. Execute the code. It says enter a valid initial. Is everything okay in the code? Emily says, what about lower cases? Perfect, Emily. Let us change that one to lowercase s and see what will we get as output. It says enter a valid initial, but user will surprise. Because user can be educated person or uneducated person. It is possible. User may put lowercase s. How can we make our code case insensitive? To do it, instead of using equals, use equals ignore case. That one. We learned that method. It checks equality by ignoring cases. Okay. I will copy and paste it over here, over here. Okay. Now lowercase s will work. Can you see it says Sunday, Saturday? uppercase S will work as well because I made my code case insensitive. Sunday and Saturday. Do you have any question about example 4, everyone? Okay. This is fifth example. Again, I am waiting for you for 3 minutes. Okay, let us start to solve it. I will create a grades container. I will make it integer. Grade, let us make it 67. Okay. I will test the other scenarios as well. Okay, everyone, let me draw a number line over here. In the number line, there is 0, 49, 50, 69, 70, 79, 80, 89, 90, 99, and 100. I have those values. I told you, when you work with numbers, you go from left to right or right to left. Over here, I will go from left to right. Okay. At the beginning, you should work with that part, everyone. Because if user gives negative value, you should give a notification to the user. I am writing it. If grade is less than 0, I will give notification system.debug negative values are not valid. I completed that part. Green part was completed. Okay. I will work with the blue part, that one. The blue part is less than 50. Pay attention, please. When you tell less than 50, normally it covers negative values. But I checked negative values at the beginning. Because of that, when I tell less than 50, Apex will not work with the negative values in the second condition. Else if grade is less than 50, I will print, it says F. I will make it F. That's it. Normally, when you tell less than 50, it contains negative values, but I checked negative values at the top. If the grade is not negative, it will come over here. Because of that, just typing less than 50 is enough. Okay, light blue part was completed. Look at here. I will work with the orange parts, 50 and 70. I will type over here, else if grade is less than 70, I checked to be less than 50 over here, because of that, that part will work just the grades between 50 and 70. It will print D. Okay. Orange part was completed. Now I will work with the pink part to be between 70 and 80. To make it faster, I will copy that one. I will copy that one. Paste it over here. Change just the values. It is 80 or 90. Did I make a mistake? 80. 80, it is C. Pink part is okay. And then purple part to be between 80 and 90. Again, I will copy that one to save time, paste it over here. It will be less than 90. The grade will be B. Okay. Purple part is completed. And that part, yellow part to be 90 and 100. So I will make it like that. Copy that one, paste it over here. Grade is less than 101 because 100 is inclusive. It should be A. Can you see? By making 101, I made 100 inclusive. So yellow part was completed as well. Now I have one more part over here. This is user. User can enter value more than 100, but more than 100 is not valid. Because of that, I will type over here else. No need to put condition because this is the last option. Every time for the last option, you may use else. I will tell values greater than 100 are not valid. Can you see? When you work with a structure like that, you will not forget any scenario. If you don't draw a number line, maybe you will forget negative values. Maybe you will forget values greater than 100. Everyone, before starting to type codes, definitely you should decide the logic. Without deciding logic, don't start to type the code. Most probably your code will not work, or you will forget some tricky scenarios. Okay. You will think you did everything, but maybe you will forget a small scenario. Let us test our code. It says D 67. It is over here. Yes, it should be D. You can test with all values. Pay attention. I will teach you how to test your code. For every scenario, you have to select a value. For example, for the green part, I mean negative values, you have to select a value. For the light blue part, I mean from 0 to 49, you should select a value. For the orange part, you should select a value. Select a value. Select a value. Select a value from here and select a value from here. Can you see? This is very simple code. Even it is so simple, you need to use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 values to test. Did it finish? Nope. Those are boundary values, everyone. You should test your code with 0 as well. Why? Because 0 is critical number. Your logic is changing when it is 0. Those are critical values. Definitely you have to test your code. Can you see 50, everyone? 50 is critical value. You have to test your code with all critical values. 70, my code is changing in 70. I have to test it. My code is changing in AD. Use AD definitely to test your code. You may think it is definitely true. Nope, everyone. You have to test your code with 90, with 100 as well. So that code must be tested at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 values. Without testing your code with 13 different values, you don't send your code to review. Okay. Nihan, over here, I defined grade as integer. If you send decimal, it will give you error because I defined as integer. If the requirement is to use decimal, define that one as decimal, and then you can use decimal values. It is possible. Everyone, that kind of test is called boundary value test. Okay, boundary value test. I don't know, did I make typo over here? Boundary value test. What is the characteristic of boundary value test, everyone? Do you know that one? The spelling of that one? Is there A after D or not? boundary that is A is? Boundary. Is it A? That one? Okay. Boundary value test. What is the characteristic of which one? This is O or A? Oh, okay. Boundary value test. Everyone, the characteristic of boundary value test is that one. All critical values must be tested. This is the first thing. And at least one value before critical value, after critical value. Can you see? Before zero, I used negative value. After zero, I used a positive value. 50 is critical value. I tested, and a value before 50, a value after 50. 80 is a critical value. I tested by using 80, and a value before 80, a value after 80. This is important. Okay. Let us give 10 minutes break time. If you have any question about fifth example, you may ask after the break time. 10 minutes break time, everyone. See you. Okay, everyone, break time is over. If you have any question about fifth example, you may ask. Otherwise, I will ask you another question. Sixth one. You may copy and paste the task. If the person is male, you will check his age. If the age is less than 16, we will print should go to school. If the age is less than 16, we will print should work. So 66. If the age is greater than 65, we will type should be retired. Same thing with different values will work for the females. Okay. Pay attention. At the beginning, I will think about the logic. Over here, I am talking about ages. If age is negative, my code should give notification without doing anything. Let me create a string for gender at the beginning. I will make it male. Okay. And I will create another container for age. Let us make it 13, for example. That's it. In my code, I will check age. But if age is negative, my code should give notification. It is the first thing. If age is less than zero, I mean negative, I am giving a message directly, system.debug negative ages are not valid. Okay. At the beginning, I am checking the age. And then I should check the gender, because if the gender is male, I will do something. If the gender is female, I will do another thing. Because of that, over here, I will type else if gender that equals ignore case. Why am I using equals ignore case? Because user can give me gender like that or all in lower cases or all in upper cases. It shouldn't be problem. I am using equals ignore case male. Okay, that one. If the gender is male, what will I do? I will check the age, everyone. Pay attention. I will check the age. If age is less than 16, it will print system.debug. It will print should go to school. Put semicolon over here. I completed that part. It says if the age is less than 66, it means I will put else if age is less than 66, it will print should work. I completed first one, second one. This is the last option, final option. For the final options, we don't type condition. We use just else to make Apex faster. It will be retired. Should be retired. Look at here. I completed male part. I didn't type anything for female yet. Pay attention, please. Over here, I have an if statement. This is an if statement. Skip else for now. You may think that one just if. The red one is if statement. As you see, inside the if, I have another if. That one. This is another if. Blue if is inside the red if. I put if into another if. Everyone, if you use if in another if, that structure is called nested if. Okay, that one is called nested if. Nested if. Everyone knows nested tables. That one. A table, we are having another table in it, like that. Because of that, we name it nested table. This is same logic. And if inside another if, it is called nested if. Actually, we don't prefer to use nested if. Because it is time consuming. If you create nested if structure, it will make Apex slower. We don't prefer it. But sometimes it is being must to use. Because of that, you should know how to type nested if. Is there any question about nested if? I think I will share it. Okay. I completed that part, highlighted part, male part. Now I am starting to the female part. I will type over here, else if gender equals ignore case female. I will make it female. If gender equals female, I will start to check age. If age is less than, in the task it says 18, less than 18, it should print should go to school, that one. Should go to school. And then else if age is less than 60, it should print should work. For the final condition, no need to use condition over here. Just I will put else and it will be retired. Should be retired. Okay. For the females, again, I used nested if. That's it. Okay. And over here, everyone, gender condition male, gender condition female, but someone can define himself different from male and female. For them, I will put else over here, and then I will tell system.debug not defined, for example. There is no any rule for the other genders. My code will work just for male and females. If someone defines himself different from those, he will get not defined message on the console. Okay. Let me explain that part from the beginning. Everyone, if the age is negative, no need to check gender, because definitely it will be, it will give notification error message. I put it at the beginning. It will make my code faster. If you check negativity after checking gender, it will be extra task. No need to do it. When you type code, possible error messages should be given at the beginning without doing anything. It will make your code faster. Because of that, I am checking age at the beginning. If age is positive, I can start to work with gender. Can you see? I am working with male over here. I checked the gender and then I started to check age. Okay. if age is less than 16, that message will be given. If the age, if the gender is not male, is female, I will start to check ages. That one. If the gender is different from male and female, that part will be executed. Is there any question? I will test with different values. This is nested if. You should know it. Okay. What do you think? If the gender is male and age is 13, what should the output be? For those values, what is the output? Should go to school. You mean that one. Let us draw and understand. Everyone, Apex will come over here. Put 13. 13 is less than zero. This is false. If it is false, I will not get error message. Apex is looking for true. Because of that, it will come to the second condition. In the second condition, it checks the gender. My gender is male, as you see at the top. It is male. Male equals male. This is true. If it is true, Apex will start to work with that part. Okay. It says age is less than 16. Age is 13. This is true. It is less than 16. If it is true, that part will be executed. After executing that part, Apex will not read else, if, and else. That part will not be read. Okay. And then Apex found true over here in the male part. Because of that, it will not read those as well. Just that four lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines will be read by Apex. Over here, there are many lines of codes, but just 5 lines will be read. It will make Apex so fast. Let us work with another scenario. I will make it female, and I will make the age 65. Okay. What is your output? With female and 65, what will you get on the console? Female. Female. Not male, female. Okay, let us check over here. First part is false. That one is false. Why? Because age is 65, 65 is not less than zero. I will not get any error message. Apex will come to the second condition. In the second condition, I am checking gender to be male. My gender is female at the top, as you see. This is female. Female equals male. It is false. If it is false, that part will not be executed, everyone. Apex is looking for true. It will come over here. The gender is female. Look at the condition. Female equals female. It is true. If it is true, that part will be executed. Put the age. It is 65. 65 is less than 18. It is false. If it is false, no execution for that one. Put 65 over here. Less than 60. It is false. No execution for should work. Else part has no any condition. That part will be executed. You will have should be retired on the console. At the end, I have else part. It will not be read because Apex found true over here. After finding true, next code will not be read. I hope this is clear. Okay. Let's see. To make that one clear, I will give you one more example about nested if. It is very similar to that one. I want you to type the code. This is seventh example. You have 3 minutes. For the seventh example, I am waiting for you. I will create a container for password string. I will name it as pwd equals to. I will type the password like gxmd exclamation mark, for example. Put that one. Okay. I have to type code to get first character of the password and last character of the password because I need to use first character. I need to use last character, okay? And then second and third characters. Let us create them. String first means first character equals to, I will go to password, I will use char add method with zero. I hope everyone remembers. Char at zero will give you the first character. Because strings use indexes. This is index zero, index one, two, three, and four. If you wanna get first character, you should use char at zero. That's it. Okay. Now I will get the last character. String last equals to go to password and then char at. Everyone, I need that one. I need that one. What should I type over here? Yes, I should type length minus one. If you type four, it will be hard coding. If you type four over here, your code will work just with that password. If you wanna make your code dynamic, I mean, will work for all values, you shouldn't type over here four. I will type length minus one. Password dot length minus one. I had explained that part, but let me explain again. Maybe someone forgot. Everyone, my string is Ali, for example. As you know, Ali has three characters in it. I mean, when you use length method, it will give you three. Length method gives you three because length method gives you the number of characters in a string. Okay, let us look at the index of last character. 0, 1, 2. Can you see? It is 3. Length is 3. Last index is 1 less than the length. Because of that, over here, I am typing length minus 1 to get the last index. We had talked about it. Just I want to remind you. Okay. That one will give me the last character. Okay. In the question, everyone, it says second and third. Let us find them as well. Okay. Second and third. String second equals to password dot char at. I will put over here one. Why? Can you see? X is the second character. Its index is one. To get second character, you should put one over here. Let us type the code to get the third character. Go to password, use char at method. For the third character, can you see M is the third character? Its index is two. I will put two over here. Okay. When I look at the question, I understood I need first character, I found it. I need last character, I found it. I need second and third characters, I found them. Now I am ready to type my if statements. Okay, if everyone. It says first character should be uppercase. This is my first character. Oh, I made mistake over here. Everyone, pay attention. I made mistake because char at method gives you integer in Apex. When you use char at, your container should be integer container. Okay. Change strings to integer. I am repeating. In Apex, char at method returns integer. Because of that, your container should be in integer data type. Okay. Now, over here, I will get the first one. It should be greater than 64. Why? Because in ASCII table, upper cases start from 65. Let us open an ASCII table. Let me clear the screen. This is our ASCII table. Can you see? Upper cases, that one. It is 65. Because of that, I typed over here 64, greater than 64. Look at the Z over here. It is 90. Okay. So if you wanna be uppercase, you should be between 65 and 90. Okay. 65 and 90. How can you type it in the code? Greater than 64 and less than 91. Did we learn AND operation with you? Okay. I am telling to Apex, hey, Apex, if first character's ASCII value is greater than 64 and less than 91, it will be uppercase. Okay. It will be uppercase. And then I checked that part. Okay. It says last character must be question mark, second character must be X. Now I am checking the last and the second. If last must be question mark equals to, what is the ASCII value of question mark? It here, question mark, where is it? That one, can you see? It is 63. Question mark is 63. If last character equals to 63 and second character must be X, what is the value of X? It is lowercase x in the task. Come over here. Lowercase x is 120. So I will put over here 120. Second character. Second equals to 120. If that one is true, I will print system.debug valid password. If any one of them is not true, it will go to else part and it will print invalid password. Okay. How is that part, everyone? I worked with ASCII values. I completed that part. If you have any question, you may. Otherwise, I will start to type the second part. It is very similar with the first part. I am typing. Will we need to write ASCII after if? Without using ASCII values, how can you understand that one is question mark, that one is lowercase x or first one is uppercase. You have to type it. Okay. Else if, everyone, I am starting to that part. It will start with lowercase. You may use substring, but I don't recommend it. Char at is the best way to use over here. Of course, in coding, a task can be done in many ways every time, but I am trying to teach you the best practice. Okay. In Apex, to understand if a character is uppercase or lowercase, using char at is the best option. Okay. First, everyone, it says lowercase. Look at the lowercases. They are starting from 97. So if I am greater than 96, I will be lowercase. So first is greater than 96. And first is less than, can you see? Lowercases are ending at 122 over here. If I am less than 123, it means I am lowercase, 123. And then I will check the last and the third characters. It says last character must be exclamation mark. I will look at the ASCII value of exclamation mark. Where is it? It is over here. Can you see it is 33? Okay. So I will type over here last equals to 33 and third character must be M. So third equals to, what is the ASCII of M? It is 109, as you see. I will put 109 over here. If the two conditions are true, password will be valid. If any one of them is false, I will tell password is invalid. That's it. Okay, that part was completed as well. But there is one more thing. User can put a digit in the first character. For digits, there is no being uppercase or lowercase. Or user can put space character at the beginning or any symbol at the beginning. For space character and symbols, there is no being uppercase or lowercase. Because of that, over here, I will type else. It means for all other scenarios, different from being letter. I will tell invalid password. That's it. Okay. Let us talk a little bit more about that one. Char at zero. When you put zero, it will go to the character at index zero. It is G over here. It is G. But char at gives its ASCII value. What is the ASCII value of G? Could you please look at it? It is 103. Let me use it like that. When you use zero in char at, it will go to the string. It will get the character at index zero. This is G. But char at doesn't give you the character. It gives you the ASCII value. It is 103. So inside the first container, there is 103, everyone. Don't forget, first is 103. Look at the second one. What is the length? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Length minus 1 will be 4. That one is 4. Okay. Char at 4 will give you exclamation mark. Because it will go to the string, it will look at the character at index 4. Its index is 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. But char at every time gives you the ASCII value. What is the ASCII value of exclamation mark? It is over here, it is 33. Okay. Because of that, from here, you will get 33. And 33 will be put into the last container over here. Inside the last, you have 33. When you use char at with 1, it will give you x, because its index is 1. You will get x, but it will give you the ASCII value of x. As you see over here, it is 120. Inside the second container, you will have 120 in it. Same thing will happen for the third one. It will give you the character at index 2. It is M. Okay, this is M. ASCII value of M is 109, as you see over here. It is 109. 109 will be put into the third container. That's it. Okay. Now, come over here to the first part. What is my first? It is 103. 103 is greater than 64. That part is false. Everyone, in AND operation, if you have a single false, the result will be false. If condition is false, if the condition is false, that part will not be executed. You cannot see valid password from the first part or invalid password. What will Apex do? Apex will come to the next condition. Put 103 over here. It is true because 103 is greater than 96. Put 103. It is true again, because it is less than 123. True and true, we learned that one, will give you true. This is true. If it is true, that code will be executed. That part will be executed. Oh yeah, I made mistake. Thank you, Canda. Let me fix it. This is true, next part is false. That part is true, everyone. But that part is false. the result doesn't change. That part is false. True and false will be false. That part will not be executed. Focus on the green part, please. It says last equals to 33. Can you see? Last is 33. That part is true. It says third equals to 109. Look at the third orange. It is 109. That one is true as well. True and true will be true. When you execute that code, it will give you valid password. GXMD exclamation mark is valid password. Okay. You may test your code with different passwords as well. Let us execute that one if I can get valid or not. Let me close door. Okay. I will execute that code. It should give me valid password. Can you see it gave me valid password? Okay. Kamile, please change the names. First, last, second, third. I think you did copy paste. Copy paste makes you fast, but you should be careful to update after copying and pasting. In IT area, there is copy paste issue. In the meetings, you will see someone will tell you, this is copy paste issue, sorry, something like that, okay? Okay. If I change that one, everyone, to G, what will be the output? I changed it to uppercase G. What is the output? Don't run the code, just think. Okay, uppercase V, what is 86? Okay, let us draw that one. First character will be G. Its ASCII value is 86. Okay. So the value of first is 86. The value of last, everyone, could you please remind me? It is 33, I think. Exclamation mark is 33, that one. And X was 109, I think. Sure was. Let me check it. Uppercase G is 71. Yes, you are correct. It is 71. Let me make it 71. This is 71. X was 109, I think. Yo, 120. What was the X, everyone? 120, I think. Lowercase X. 120. Lowercase M was 109. Let us check the code by using those values. Focus on over here. First is 71. 71 is greater than 64. It is true. 71 is less than 91. It is true. True and true will give me true. So that code will work. It says last. What is the last? It is 33. Okay. 33 equals to 63. It is false. If it is false, no need to check second part. That one will be false. If it is false, that code will not be executed. Else part will be executed automatically. You will see invalid password on the console. Okay. You may review those codes with different passwords. Okay. For now, that's enough, I think. Okay. We have 20 more minutes, everyone. I will start to teach you ternary. We will do a couple of examples. Next session, we will go on to talk about ternary. Ternary statement. Ternary does the same with if else by using different syntax. I am repeating. Ternary does the same with if else by using different syntax. I am sharing the code. Ahmed, I am sharing the code. Copy and paste, it will work. Let me put a note over here. Ternary statement does the same with if else. If else statement by using simpler syntax. Does the same by using a more simple syntax. More simple syntax. Okay. I will type an if statement at the beginning, and then I will type the same by using ternary to show you the difference. Let us make it if I will create a grade over here, integer grade GPA, integer GPA equals to 3.8, change it to decimal. Okay. If GPA is greater than 3.8, make it 3.9. Okay. It will print cut scholarship. Else didn't get scholarship. I typed in the same line to be able to compare with ternary. Type it like that, please, in the same line. When you use ternary, everyone, when you use ternary, you will not type if, you will not put parentheses, okay, you will type just the condition. I told you, its syntax is more simple. Type over here, GPA is greater than 3.8. Okay. And then, after typing the condition, you will put question mark. Okay. And then, you will put the output over here. Can you see? Those parts were not typed. I didn't type those. I got just that part. It is more simple. And then you will put colon every time. And then you will put just the output, second output. Of course, at that you will put semicolon. Can you see? I didn't type those as well. Because of that, I am telling ternary is more simple than if statement. If your syntax is simple, it will be more readable. Okay, how will that code work? Let us talk about the flow. Can you see? This is, everyone, 3.9. I will put 3.9 over here. 3.9 is greater than 3.8. This is true. That statement is true. If it is true, Apex will get first one. I mean, between question mark and colon. That one will be the result. This is the result. Okay. Let us talk about negative scenario. In negative scenario, let me make GPA 3.5, for example. 3.5 is greater than 3.8. That statement is false. If the condition is false, Apex will go to the second part. I mean, the part between colon and semicolon. That one will be the result. Okay. For happy scenario, first part will be executed. For negative scenario, second part will be executed. Ahmet, ternary does the same with if else. If you want, use if else. But ternary is more simple to type. Ternary is more readable. Because of that, most of the times we prefer to use ternary instead of if else. Okay. In some resources, you may read ternary is faster than if else, but in Salesforce documentation, I didn't see anything like that. I don't know if ternary is faster than if else. I didn't read anything in Salesforce documentation. Okay, but you should know how to use ternary. Because sometimes companies put coding standards. You should type your code according to the company's coding standards. If they put a standard like use ternary instead of if else, you should use it. Okay. And most of the times, ternary is preferable. It is more advanced than if else. As you see, instead of typing many parentheses, if, else, curly braces, you are typing just the mandatory things. That's it. It is better. Okay. When you type that code, for happy scenario, you will get that one as output. This is string. For negative scenario, you will get that one as output. It is string as well. So I will create a string container to store the output in it. If that one will be given to me, I will put it into result. If the second one will be given to me, I will put it into result. And then let us print it on the console, system.debug result. Okay. That one is the first way. That one is the second way. Both should give me the same output. First output will come from if else, second output will come from ternary. Let us run all that part. Can you see? Got scholarship. Both gave me the same output. This is positive scenario, worked. Let us make it 3.5. It will be negative scenario because 3.5 is not greater than 3.8. I should get didn't get scholarship from if else and from ternary, that one is false. I should get the second part. Again, didn't get scholarship. Sometimes it is freezing. Did you get the output? Can you see? Didn't get scholarship. Both worked. Okay. So, when you type, everyone, when you type ternary, what is your syntax? Let me put it over here. You will type the condition at the beginning, condition, and then you will put question mark, and then that part, the code for true condition. Okay. That one. And then you will put over here colon, and then the code for false condition. When you complete that five steps, it means you typed your ternary. That's it. Let us do one more. For false, Canan. Today you are finding all my mistakes. Thank you. Okay. You do that one. This is the last question for today. This is example 8. Yes. Nihan, you have to type that 5 steps every time. This is example 8, everyone, not 7. You can do that one, I think. Waiting for you for 3 minutes. Okay, Ahmet, you asked the usage of question mark. It means that one. This is condition. Condition true or false? Okay, it is asking. This is condition. Condition true or false? If it is true, that part will be executed. If it is false, that part will be executed. Okay. I will create an integer container, I equals to 8, for example. Esma's solution is okay. I will copy from there. This is 8. What will we type at the beginning for ternary? I will type condition. What is the condition? Condition is to be even or odd. We learned how to check if a number is even or odd. Go to math class, use mod methods. Mod method will use two parameters. First parameter will be the number. Second parameter will be 2. Mod method will divide my number by 2 and will give me the remainder. If the remainder is 0, it means it is even. If that part is true, it means my number is even. Because of that, I will type over here even. If that condition is false, I should print odd over here because it will not be even. This is my code. Let me explain that part. Okay. As you see, I equals to 8. Put 8 over here. What will mod method do? Mod method will divide 8 by 2, 4 times, it is 8. As you see, remainder is 0, everyone. Remainder is 0. Over here, it says equals to 0. I found 0, it says equals to 0. That part is true. If the condition is true, that one will be executed. It will tell me even, 8 is even, it is correct. Let us change the number to 9, for example. 9 is not even, I should get odd. When you put 9 over here, mod method will divide 9 by 2. 4 times 9 equals to 8, it is 1. Can you see? Remainder is 1, but it says equals to 0. 1 doesn't equal to 0. It is false. If it is false, not the first part. Second part will be executed. I will get odd. As you see, 9 is odd. It is working. Of course, for positive scenario, you are getting string. For negative scenario, you are getting string. So you should create a string container. Name it as result. You may put any name, no problem. And then printed on the console. For 9, I should see odd. Can you see it told me odd? Let us make it 8. I should get even. Okay. It worked as you see. It says even. Of course, you should test your code with negative values as well. For example, negative 28. This is even. When you execute, you should get even on the console. It is even. Okay. This is the introduction to ternary. In the next session, we will do more examples. We will learn nested ternary as well. We learned nested if over here. Okay. Everyone, we completed if statements. The questions in the book, I mean test questions and code questions, both are your homeworks. Until the next session, please complete them all. Okay. See you in the next session. Have a good day.